Welcome back to Agilent Technologies' video series on care and use of turbomolecular pumps. In this video, we are going to cover the proper venting and shutdown of a turbomolecular pump. Most turbo pumps consist of very tight tolerances existing between non-rotating stators and spinning rotor blades, supported by some form of suspension system. When shutting down a vacuum system, it is critical to never introduce such a gas load that would deflect the rotor blades where contact could happen with the stators. The following procedure will show the proper steps to shut down our turbo pump when venting to atmosphere. There are two different options for properly venting the Agilent turbomolecular pump. The manual vent valve is used to gradually introduce room air into the middle of the turbo's rotor stack, slowing the rotor in a controlled manner. Once I have hit the stop button on the front panel or in T+, I can slowly open the manual vent valve about a quarter turn until I hear the turbo start to slow down. Once the pump has dropped below 50% of its maximum operating speed, I can open the manual vent valve completely, allowing the rotor to come to a complete stop. The turbo pump is now stopped and we can power off safely. For customers who don't want room air entering their vacuum system or who don't have hands-on access to the pump, or even those who simply want a more repeatable vent cycle, Agilent offers automated vent valves that connect to the turbo controllers and allow users to precisely tailor the vent sequence for their application. The electronic valve can be installed easily and in the same threaded hole as the manual vent screw. When you're ready to shut down your turbo pump system, you can hit stop on the turbo pump. The automated vent valve will automatically engage and slow the turbo pump down at a very safe level. You can see here that the location of the vent valve on the 84FS turbo is roughly in the center of the pump's blade section. That means that the gas entering the pump is distributed evenly and doesn't drastically lift the suspended rotor or drop it against its spring-loaded suspension. That way, we practically eliminate the possibility of exceeding those tight clearances between rotating and stationary components. Now that we have shown you how to properly vent your turbo pump, let's discuss some of the worst ways you can treat your turbo. Probably the worst way to vent a turbo pump under vacuum is to open a four-line connection, either at the turbo exhaust or at the backing pump inlet. Not only does this violently shock the rotor with a gas load, but can also force any backstreamed oil or particulates from the four-line into your body of your pump and ultimately into the vacuum chamber. This is a bad idea on all counts. The final topic I'm going to cover in this video is the concept of electric braking of the rotor, a feature built into Agilent's newest generation of turbo controllers. When the pump is now at normal operation and we press the stop command, braking will engage electronically and slow the turbo pump down in a safe manner without allowing atmospheric air or any other gas load into the system. By enabling this option on your controller or through T+ software control, I can instruct the controller to use the electric motor of the turbo to slow it down. In effect, turning the motor into a generator. This extraction of power from the rotor increases its deceleration rate, allowing the rotor to come to a safe speed much faster than if it were left to spin down on its own. The exact mechanism for doing this varies between the controller models, but the basic concept is the same in all cases: a smooth controller shutdown sequence that can prolong the life of your turbo pump. Now we can safely turn off our unit. I'm Bartley Carlson with Agilent Technologies.